In this video, we're going to look at an easy way to figure out the charges for ions containing one atom. When it comes to forming ions, metals will donate its electron to form cation, which is a positively charged ion. While metalloids and non-metals, they will accept electrons and therefore they will form an ion, which is a negatively charged ion. Generally, the charges on metals in the main group will follow the group number, meaning group 1 elements will have a plus 1 charge. This is because it's easier to give away one valence electron to achieve octet, like noble gases, which makes them very stable. So it's easier to give away one electron than to accept 7 valence electrons in order to get that 8 valence electron like noble gases. So we apply the same reasoning for metals in group 2A and 3A, and that's why metals in group 2A will form plus 2 charge, whereas metals in group 3A will form plus 3 charges. For non-metals, well, instead of giving away electrons, it's actually easier for them to accept electrons. Let's take group 5A for example. Group 5A elements will need to accept 3 electrons in order to become octet, because they already have 5, so in order to become 8, all they have to do is just take in 3. It will be easier to take in 3 electrons rather than giving away 5 electrons, because 3 is a smaller number than 5. So therefore, getting in 3 electrons will make it a negative 3 charge. In fact, there's a shortcut in calculating the charge for these metalloids and non-metals, which is you take the group number and then you subtract 8. So let's give it a try. So 5 minus 8 will give us negative 3. And for elements in group 6A, which are the chalcogens, it will give us negative 2. And the same thing for a halogen, it will give us negative 1. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward to determine the charge of ions in the main group. Main group are the elements with group A. I wish I could say the same for transition metals, which are the ones in the middle here, and some of the elements in group 4A. They make more than one type of ion. That means they have different types of charges. Therefore, there's no easy correlation that we can make. So what I've done is I've just placed some of the commonly known ions for the transition metals and a few members of group 4A. To recap, metals donate electrons to form positive ions. The charge of metals from main group is the same as their group number. Non-metals and metalloids will accept electrons to form negative ions, and the charge of non-metals and metalloids is basically their group number minus 8. Hope that was helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.